Henderson to McDonald. Johnston. Steen and Denny. Johnston out in front. Steen. Sitting forward. Johnston scores. A beautiful header from Willie Johnston's cross.
I think scoring that goal in the final will remain with me for the rest of my life. I think most places I go all around the world these days where there are Rangers fans, and that's what they say.
To produce one of the most unlikely match winners.
McGree, putting young after him. Well, referee awarding a free kick. Farley, over the behind. Johnston, a beautiful ball to McLeish, it's a goal, a beautiful goal by McLeish, Kane put through the middle, beautifully, Celtic 1-0 up, 24 and a half minutes gone, and the Rangers defenders have been steadfast down the middle, cut out, as that ball was pushed through to McLeish. And he's so adept at taking a defence on like that. And McCloy had absolutely no chance as it breaks past him. And Muddock pushing McDonald. Greg to take this. No. Once again it's left. Here's Matheson. Andy McDonald, 11 minutes to half time. It's a good ball, it's a goal! Carlin the scorer. Thirty-four minutes of the game gone. Celtic 1, Rangers 1. And that came from that long through ball towards Alec McDonald. He struggled well, managed to get in the clear and put it over. And Derek Carlin, who's done that so often this season, was right on the spot. Celtic kick off. Score one each. Anything could happen in this match. Here's Quinton Young for Rangers. As towards Kahn. Kahn going through. And it's there. The goal for Rangers. Rangers 2, Celtic 1, within about 30 seconds of the second half kickoff. And that long through ball coming to Kahn. Kahn looking as if he might have pushed it too far, but getting the final touch and putting Rangers one up at this vital stage. There's Derek Johnston, Jardine, Rogan for Celtic, up to Callaghan. That's a good ball to Johnston. And here's Deans with a chance. Tremendous confusion in the Rangers goal back there. And it looks like a penalty kick. It's a penalty. Penalty to Celtic. George Connolly to take it. This is a vital one for Celtic. And he's done it. That's the equaliser. Well, that was ricocheting about the crowded Rangers penalty area there. The hand used and the penalty kick awarded. And George Connolly made no mistake with it. Two each, and this is a fantastic cup final. And it's side getting the final touch. It looked as if the ball was going in any case, and that's 3-2 for Rangers. At 15 minutes of the second half gone, that ball came across. It looked as if it was trembling. First of all, past the post, onto the post, static on the line, and for side lying handy, pushed it across.
There was first trophy of the season is always important, because that got you into Europe, and beating Celtic was great, especially your oldest rivals again.
So there's John Gregg. And there's the Scottish League Cup. And there's the roar from the Rangers fans. No sign of the rest of the Rangers team. Sandy Jordan finally appearing behind them. Rangers fans. Quinton Young, Collins team. Alan McDonald, the man who scored the goal midway through the second half. And for Stuart Kennedy, a fairy tale return to the Rangers first team, drafted into the team in midweek in Europe, and now a League Cup medal on the Saturday after being sidelined through injury and then eventually losing his place to Peter McCloy.
I've sailed the wild Atlantic, crossed the broad Pacific shore. I've sailed around the stormy capes and heard
the been won. Now Rangers could clinch the treble by beating Hearts in the Scottish Cup final at Hampden.
Hearts have won the toss, so Rangers kick off in the 1976 Scottish Cup final, the first meeting in the final between the two sides since 1903. There's the first free kick on the match, so Rangers midway inside the half. Trying to plot something.
good try at Gary time. Colin Jackson moving down. Keep putting it in. Now McDonald.
Smith. just going in the outside, but running into trouble. Comes it out in front. Cooper scores! Cooper scores for Rangers. 6 minutes from half time. Dave Cooper's seventh goal of the season. Made by Gordon Smith. Finished off by Dave Cooper's far to left foot.
Out to McLean. To Rangers. Donald looking up into the sun for that one. Sneddon is onside, that's a good move. Edvaldsen, goal!
Out of nothing, Celtic score! Edvaldsen, his 10th goal of the season. 5 minutes to go, and Celtic from nowhere have fought back and scored a tremendous equaliser. All happened down the right-hand side. On the right, got his cross over. The ball moved in with Jackson. Kennedy came off his line. The ball finished up in the back of the net.
3 minutes remaining. Smith to Johnston. Miller coming up as the extra man. There's his cross. There's Latchford. The ball spinning loose.
Headed in by Smith, and the referee's giving a goal. Gordon Smith scores. 3 minutes from the end of extra time. His 25th goal of the season. And for the second time of the match, Rangers were into the lead. Alec Miller came up on the overlap. Picked up that ball wide. Made space very quickly in the field. Putting it across, right-footed. Latchford committed himself, punched it away, and Smith followed up, headed the ball into the net.
Defeated 1-0 by Celtic in the following year's final, Rangers met Aberdeen in the 1978 final, hoping to write another chapter in the club's remarkable history.
Unlike McLean to lose possession where there was no challenge on him like that. Gordon Smith to Cooper. Johnston looking for support. Poynton and Russell. There's Alec McDonald, it's there! Alec McDonald scores the opening goal of the cup final. 11 minutes to halftime. Good tackle by Gregg and Russell and Sullivan following up. That should be a throw to Rangers. Lane does well to sweep that in. There's Johnston, yes! Sullivan. Not really seen Sullivan as effective as he's been in there for Aberdeen, not consistently this season. Seen him score some excellent goals. Harper. Well, there's a chance, and there's McCloy, and it's there.
The ball went the other.
Johnston. The referee turned round and immediately waved rugby off. So into the third minute of injury time as the train lines up with this free kick. That's the last kick of the regulation 90 minutes plus. McLean, Jackson, goal! Colin Jackson scores the third minute of injury time and it's all over. McLean took the free kick. Jackson was there and the ball bulleted into the net to make the score Rangers 2, Aberdeen 1.